Good morning, dear students. Students, today we are going to continue chapter 4, division. Under this chapter, today we are going to discuss about the unitary method. Before understanding the unitary method, we should know what is the meaning of unitary. Okay, so unitary, the word unitary has come from the word unit, and unit means one. Unit means one. Okay, so in this method, what we have to do is we have to find the value of one unit. Okay, now we will see how to find the value of one unit. We will find the value of one unit by the division process. The first operation that we will apply in it is a division, and after that we will find value of required number of units. How we will find the value of required number of units? By multiplying. So students, always remember that in unitary method we have to follow two things. Okay, this method involves first division and multiplication. Okay, now let us do some example. So students, if you see, there are three apples. 1, 2, 3. And the cost of that three apple is rupees 18. Okay, now we have five more apples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now they are asking, now tell us the cost of five apples. How we will find out? Okay, we will find out it with the help of unitary method. Let us take an example. The cost of three apples is rupees 18. Find the cost of five apples. Okay, they have given us the cost of three apples. With the help of that cost, we will find the cost of one apple. Okay, we have to find the cost of one unit. Okay, one unit, how we will find it? By dividing, by division method. So what we will write here? We will write it here, cost of 3 apples is equals to rupees 18. Okay, now what we will do, we will find out the cost of one apple. So we will write cost of one apple is equals to 18 divided by 3. Okay, so how we will find it out? We will divide it with 3. 3, 6 are 18. So as you see, the cost of one apple is equals to rupees 6. Now they are asking us to find out the cost of five apples. How? Now we will know the cost of one apple. With the help of this cost, we will find out the cost of so many apples. Here in this example, they are asking the cost of five apples. So we will write it here, cost of five apples is equals to 6 multiplied by 5, that is 6 fives are 30. So the cost of five apples is rupees 30. Okay, this way you can solve your example. Okay, so students, always remember that when you have cost of so many apples and you have to find out the cost of one unit. Okay, if you have cost of so many units and you have to find out the cost of one unit, simply what you will do, you will do the division. Okay, when we have a bigger number and we go to the smaller number, we will divide. Okay, and now if we want to get a bigger number, in that process we will multiply. Okay, let us take another example. Another example is, there are 145 balloons in 5 packets. Okay, firstly you have to read it twice. There are 145 balloons in 5 packets. How many balloons will be there in 40 such packets? Okay, so it's better if you want to understand the statement word problem, so you have to read it twice so that you can understand it in a better way. So let us do the solution. what you will write? Number of balloons, number of balloons in 5 packets. Number of balloons in 5 packets is equals to 145. Okay, now we have to find out the number of balloons in 1 packet. As you know, how we will find it out? We will find it out with the help of, yes, division. So, number of balloons in 1 packet is equals to 145 divided by 5. Now we will do the division process. 5, 2s are 10. What will left? 45. 5, 9s are 45. As you see, in this example, we will get 29. So, how many packets are there? 29. How many balloons are there? 29 balloons in 1 packet. Okay. Now, what we have to do is, they are asking how many balloons will be there in 40 such packets. So, we will find out number of balloons in 40 packets is equals to 29 multiplied by 40. Now you will multiply 29 with 40 and you will get the answer. Okay, 0, 0. 4 9s are 36, 3, carry over. 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. And what will be the answer? 1160. Okay, so we will write here 1160 balloons. So in 5 packets, in 5 packets, 145 balloons are there. In 1 packet, we will find it with the help of the division, that is 29 balloons. After that, now we know how many balloons are there in 1 packet, that is 29. Then we can easily calculate the number of balloons in 40 packets. So, we will multiply 29 with 40 and we get the required answer. Okay, this way you will do your unitary method. So, students, you have to revise exercise 4.6 today. Try to solve exercise. Try to do it in rough notebook. Okay, I hope you understand this concept of unitary method. Thank you and have a nice day.